What the hell is that? Forte says, what's that? It looks like black and fire, says Una. Fred's like, it was here, as I expected. Forte says, there's a stone monument, some writings are carved on it. The same characters on the resonance stone are used on the stone monument. McBain says, it looks like the Water Tribe used these characters, but it's more difficult than the words Leon used on the resonance stone. This is difficult for me to read this. It's time for me to lend them a helping hand. Fred's mumbling. Let's see. Can you read it? Asked Forte. Are you sure? Dark Sun, Fred says. Oh? Says Una. Well, we seal the Dark Sun here to warn the future. This is the evidence of our sins. Spells were the cause of our destruction. Yet spells were also the saviors of the world. That's what it says. Evidence of their sins, says McBain. Then this is the... Forte says, embers of evil power sealed by the Water Tribe which we heard about in Shulf. It was here all this time. Embers. Oh, this is the evil that this sealed away. Here reminds... really random, reminds me of an old episode of Star Trek The Next Generation where a crew member actually dies. Spoiler, I'm not going to say who then, because spoiler, I can say, but... Yeah, so the whole thing is there was this, basically, thing, it just looked like an oil slick, or, you know, some black-colored water or something like that, food coloring and oil or something. And, there was a race of angelic beings who, like, removed all the evil from their souls and decided to discard it on this planet, but the evil was sentient, and the evil was this, like, oil slick thing. Really kind of strange episode when you think about it. But, yeah, so it was the evil left behind by the angelic beings. And you start to, I mean, some of the crew members start to feel bad for the evil. Because it was abandoned there, and it's been there for thousands of years, something like that. Yeah. So if they were so good, why did they do an evil thing and leave it behind all by itself to suffer, right? And it's called the Dark Sun, says Una. Okay, that's the Dungeons and Dragons campaign. I guess the purpose of building this place was to seal it, McBain says. The menace of the Water Tribe. Oh! That's the Water Tribe's menace, not necessarily that the Water Tribe has menace for us. Forte says, yes, we gotta collect resonance stones for when the time comes. At any rate, you're great, Fred, says Ada. How'd you do that? How come you could read it, says Una. I need to study hard to deceive people. Do you know that the con men are hard-working people? You've got so many hidden talents, says McBain. Alright, let's get back. We may be able to find out more from the chief. Really? I thought we were going to fight this thing. We seal the Dark Sun here to warn the future. This is the evidence of our sins. Spells were the cause of our destruction, yet spells are also the saviors of the world. Yeah, indeed. Very interesting. I was looking to see if there's, like, any hidden tunnel. Way to go. Alright. The menace of the Water Tribe, indeed. I forgot, did we come across any monsters in here? I don't think I did. Now we're back to regular lava cave time. Blah, blah, blah. Looking forward to buying all these weapons and armor. Thank you. Time to kill! Sweet. Interrupt. Bot crash. Power store? Oh, it raised its attack. And that one just missed. I think this one's damaged by Una. Jump rush! No, you can't reach that. But you can. McBay, level 28. Una, Forte, Jan and Rick. Nice. Now Ada just needs to catch up. I'm gonna get the surprise. Yay! No attack. Magic. Magic attack. Another ice rain. Maybe he can kill all these guys. Well, not the golem, but all the hellhounds with two ice rains. Let's see. Oh, I've charge dog. Charge dog! The charge dog's gonna help with the hellhound killing. Never mind, we don't get to find that out. It's okay. This will kill that other hellhound now. It should. Cool. Little healing. One point shy. All right. Fight this thing too? I think it's just one. Yeah, just one hellhound. I actually wouldn't have bothered, but it didn't occur to me until right after I decided to attack it. Okay. I need your back to me. Your back must be to me. Okay. This poor little dog going up to this huge frickin' hulking thing. Just looked funny to me for a second. I'm surprised Forte goes before Jin. Punch him! Go on, punch him! Nice. Hey, hey, Ada! Level 28. Welcome to the 28 Club. So, how much is that? I'm counting my money, you see. I'm just doing 1600 times 5 is 8,000. Wow. We have over 8,000 in roses. Okay. Which way were we going? Not this way, because this is a dead end. Pass some of these by. Think? Should I pass some of them by? Fight that one. Wait, how do we get out of here? I'm loving the ice rain against the fiery opponents. Just you now, buddy. You're doomed. Let's see if we can find our way out of here. Oh, down this way is... okay. Feels like I just dodged out of the way. Nope! I'm gonna hug the wall now. Alright, so we're going this way, right? I thought we came from this way, though. Oh, okay. Hope I'm going the right way. What's... oh, I thought there was something over here. Okay, so we're gonna go out the north screen. I'm gonna fight this thing first. That was a lot. Ice rain time. I just noticed that Forte needs a little healing. Two down. Let's see, now attack Golem C. Poor dog, he cannot reach. Interrupt. Nice. 446 points. Big cure on Forte. Pororin cure, whatever. I notice Forte goes first now. I guess he got his speed went up. I'm gonna save these fools. Full meters, I mean. Right. Out the north way. Okay, so healings. No, I don't really need. Oh. Oh wait, that's back to the underground ruins. Never mind. Okay, so we're heading south. Try to avoid that this time. Alright. So I'm guessing we go... Yeah, we have to go up those stairs because this is a dead end with the chest. And the one hellhound. So we have to go this way. There's a tunnel to the north. I think it's a dead end. It is, okay. Okay, so we have to go east then. And then north once again. Checking, there's no other way to go. Oh! I thought this was a dead end. I did not see this here. That's what messed me up. Check up here. Oh, look at that! We missed a chest. A hairpin? Not just a hairpin. That's a accessory. Oh wait. That's a quest item. That kid wanted to buy a hairpin for his sister. Isn't it? Or hair accessory? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's just a coincidence. Yeah, got a hairpin. I guess it's for us. Okay. Fashionable spiraling hair accessory. You'll feel driven. Increases spell power. Well, Ada could use it, I guess. Wow. That increased her attack power by 12 points. I mean her magic power. Does she have magic? She doesn't have magic. Okay, so wait a second. What are the dotted ribbons for? He has two of them. I mean, who knows if they stack, right? I don't know. I don't remember it. Accessories. Cute ribbon with red polka dots. The stylish ribbon increases spell power. Really? He had two of them. He was wearing a cute ribbon with red polka dots, McBain. Okay, so let's examine this. Right, if we take this off, he loses 6 magic attack. He gains 6. So just unequip it. Yeah. So the dotted ribbon will have him go up by 6. The hairpin brings him up by 12. So, cool. Upgrade. So now McBain's got a cute hairpin and a cute little dotted ribbon with polka dots. All to increase his attack power. Don't complain, McBain. It's all for the good of the group. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. Well, I guess we're gonna kill it. I hit the edge and he just automatically ran that way. McBain needs more magic. Yeah, no. Ice rain. This might be our last ice rain. This will kill the leech. And weaken the hellhound. Okay. So we're going this way, yes? Or maybe not? I almost hit that. Okay, so this isn't the way we came, right? I don't want to go back the way we came. It might be. Oops. I need an auto map, a mini map. You almost ran into me, dude. Sealed your death warrant. Oh yeah, I went back. Alright, never mind. Got pissed at us for a sec. It's like, never mind, I'll kill them. No. Actually, maybe not kill them. Okay. Do not go that way. So, do we want to go this way? Oh, that's the dead. Okay, so we need to go west then. Westish. Wait, that's a dead end, right? Okay. I'm missing one of these entrances again, I think. We came from those stairs, though. Where do I go? Dead end. Right? Dead end there. Came from those stairs there. Well, maybe this... Okay, never mind. These little ones, they... It's trickier to get back than to get there. Because the way it's laid out, you're not... You don't immediately see the way to go. Wait a second. Is this the way? Yep. It was hot like hell inside, wasn't it? Says Odessa. Being in the desert feels cool, says Fred. Oh, I'll return this to you, says McBean. He returned rock pillar key. Looks like you obtained a resonance stone. Congratulations. Chief, we saw it in the underground temple, says Forte. So, that's the... That's the evidence of our ancestors' sins, says Odessa. These underground ruins were left by the Water Tribe. The Shanoon Tribe are also descendants of the tribes on the other side. Chief Odessa, says McBean, we were asked by Chief Oratorio in Shulf to collect resonance stones. He told me pretty much everything. I see. There's also an unwritten legend in Selbart about the Dark Sun. This is how it goes. Great Menace. It left this world by the combination of the power of the melody and the peace taken out from it. However, the peace turned into blackened fire and stayed in the separated earth. This is the so-called Dark Sun. It's similar to what Chief of Shulf told us, says Una. Yeah, he said that not everything had been sealed either, Forte says. The power of resonance spells weren't strong enough for our ancestors to seal the evil power. Because of it, they started to build a huge facility to enhance the resonance spells by sympathizing. Fred, murmuring, enhancing equipment of resonance spells. Never heard of it. It's worth reporting. However, the evil power accelerated its growth day by day, and the world was about to be ruined before the facility was completed. The Water Tribe, facing its crisis at hand, made a choice. Which is? Says Forte. They used the evil power itself. The facility wasn't totally completed, but it somehow worked. The evil power is basically a mass of harmful frequencies. The waves are not entirely clear, but it is possible to create a resonance response. They used a part of the harmful frequency to supplement the facility. Poison drives out poison, says McBean. They successfully contained the main body of the evil power with the power of the facility and resonance response of harmful frequency. But the massed harmful frequency was left in this world. It was a very small amount compared to what was sealed, though. The world was saved, but the indelible black spot was left. That is the Dark Sun, which was sealed underground. I see, says Forte. I wonder if Leon also saw that blackened fire. I bet he did. Leon wanted the Resonance Stone Seeker to know about the existence of the Dark Sun. That's why he hid the stone in the ruins. It was a monster created out of harmful frequency. It's still alive after having been sealed. It's like an egg whose growth had been stopped. If it's released, it's going to start growing again by absorbing humanity's negative notions. Negative notions, says Una. As long as humans exist, negative notions such as grief, suffering, and animosity will be produced no matter what. I see, says McBean. It eats up people's grief and suffering. The world is full of negative notions. If the dark sun started growing, it would become enlarged at an accelerating pace. It's said if the dark sun gets bloated and saturated by absorbing negative notions, it'll eventually cause a big explosion. McBain says that's why Leon couldn't extinguish the resonance stones, even though he knew the danger of resonance spells. Odessa says, sorry to say this, but the lost melody was not passed down here in Selbart. Now that things have come to this, our only hope is Leon's water melody. You must complete water melody before the menace of the dark sun becomes reality. Oh, no pressure or anything, right? Complete the water melody before the menace of the dark sun turns into reality. We didn't inherit the resonance stone like the people in Shulf did. It was because we're afraid that the dark sun might activate and break the seal if resonance spells were abused. That blackened fire is a warning against excessive advance in civilization. Advance in civilization. Imagine if we sent a Terminator after it. I was overwhelmed by the chief's aura, says Ada. It just wasn't the right atmosphere to say something unnecessary, Fred says. Things are blowing bigger all of a sudden, says Una. You're right about that, McBain says, but we still don't know for sure that we will need Melody. Need Melody. Before that happens, we need to take care of it, says Fortang. That's right. Well, let us return to the Oasis. The boss may be back by now. Lost Melody, says Argus. It's a legendary piece that our ancestors composed. Leon could have restored it since he was a genius. I want to play too. And, Kachua, you have to go now? Please come by again. Yes, I promise I will, says Una. Please perform again. You're very needy. Come by again, perform again, please, please, please. We'll check around with everybody. I guess we're leaving the town after that. We gotta buy those weapons. And armor. We, the Shanoon tribe, have been guarding the ruins for a long time. That's why we take caution toward outsiders. But I admit we've been too close-minded. Alright, let's see what we can get.